Hey Mojoholics, welcome back to What's Your Mojo, the weekly show where we fill you in on what you might have missed last week, give you a sneak peek on what's coming up next week, ask your feedback, and answer viewer FAQs. Let's do this mojo style. In case you missed it, this week we published top 10 movie narrations. So if you like listening to Tom Hanks or Morgan Freeman or Kevin Spacey or me talk, then this is the clip for you.
I'm the guy who can get it for you. Cigarettes, a bag of reefer, if that's your thing.
And like I mentioned last week, we also published our top alternative band series, which included 6 videos like top 10 grunge bands, top 10 punk bands, top 10 alternative bands of the 80s, 90s, and 2000s, and the top 10 alternative bands of all time. So, if you listen to a lot of The Cure, or The Clash, or Pearl Jam, or whatever, head on over to that series and get to arguing. If April showers have turned into May showers wherever you are, never fear, Watch Mojo's here, with many videos to keep you occupied on rainy days. And sunny ones, come to think of it. Anyway, what's filling this weekend's Mojo-thon? Well, today we published top 10 funniest movie insults, tomorrow we've got top 10 memorable movie insults, and on Sunday we've got top 10 obscene movie insults for you. So if you can never think of a comeback when someone disses you, then this series should help you out famously, you smelly pirate hookers.
You are a smelly pirate hooker.
And if you feel like using your brains a tiny, tiny bit, we've also got a series on the top 10 historical influencers coming up this week. What does that even mean? Well, we've got top 10 philosophers, top 10 most influential figures in science and technology, and top 10 influential religious figures. Sure, school might be over, but you can still learn new things, impress your friends, and win at trivia. Speaking of which, are you ready for some trivia? Let's do it. Which director cites the miniatures in the original Godzilla as inspiration for the effects in his sci-fi films? George Lucas, J.J. Abrams, M. Night Shyamalan, or Sam Raimi? You are correct if you said George Lucas, who was inspired by Godzilla to create the effects in Star Wars. If you want to power through some more trivia, head over to watchmojo.com/trivia. Anyway, I'm talking to you about Godzilla because the new Godzilla movie comes out in theaters today in North America, and this year is actually Godzilla's 60th anniversary. So, if you want to celebrate the big Tokyo-destroying monster, here are some videos for you. Top 10 Godzilla movies, the origins of Godzilla, top 10 city destruction scenes in movies, and top 10 classic movie monsters. Also, don't forget to head over to watchmojo.com/calendar to see thousands of our older, equally timely videos. And make sure to vote on the topics that matter most to you so we can tailor our future videos to your tastes. Before we ask you your opinions on a few of our lists, we thought we'd show you where your hard work gets you. We published Top 10 Film Noir a couple weeks ago. This week, we've got Top 10 Songs Named After Women coming up on Thursday. And White Stripes fans, our Top 10 White Stripes songs will come out next Saturday. And I'm talking to myself at night because I can't forget. So the countdown to the countdown is on. Thanks again for your help in choosing those lists. But wait! We have even more lists in need of your input this week. To start, top 10 video games of the third generation. If you prefer Mario Brothers over The Legend of Zelda, let us know and vote for your fave. Up next, we've got top 10 underwater movie fights. What's not to like about this one? You've got action, wetness, fighting, wetness. Oh, did I say that already? Well, anyway. If you have a favorite underwater fight scene, go at it and vote on the suggest page. We've also got top 10 riffs. So if you play the guitar and can appreciate a good riff, or if you play the air guitar and can still appreciate a good riff, get on over and vote for your favorites. And as always, be sure to head over to watchmojo.com/suggest to let us know what you think. And while you're there, make sure to exercise your right to vote on any other lists you might have an opinion on. Hey team, Dan and I are back on the red couch to answer questions from the faithful Mojoholics. But first, we have to award the Speed prize packs from last week to our two lucky winners. We asked the question, what does Sandra Bullock use as an excuse to switch seats when an annoying guy is talking to her on the bus?
And while many of you answered the question quite correctly, the first two to nail the answer were Jose Alanis and Ryan Kearney. So please email us your addresses via YouTube and we'll mail you your prize.
Thanks for playing, everyone. Now, let's get to the questions. Dan, do you want to start?
Sure. I've got a question here from Daenerys Targaryen, who apparently took a break from trying to conquer the Seven Kingdoms. The Khaleesi wants to know, do Watch Mojo ever read comments? Like, do they ever go through every comment?
Do you want the short answer or the long answer? Well, we'd be lying if we said we read every single comment, but we certainly try. Nowadays, we get 10,000 comments a day across nearly 8,000 videos. It's literally impossible to read them all, but like I said, we try.
Granted, YouTube has some new tools that make it a bit easier to track the comments, but it's still pretty time consuming. That being said, like many of you have pointed out, we are one of the only channels that do actually respond to the comments.
And we care about your feedback so much, we created the suggestion tool so we can receive your feedback more easily. Up until recently, we actually only had one person replying to the comments. And surprisingly, that person did not end up in an asylum.
Well...
yeah, well, anyway. Anyway, we added more people to the staff to ensure that we can read and reply to more of your comments.
And we'll be experimenting with a new team of the most faithful WatchMojo fans, which we're thinking of calling WatchMojo Fellows or Mojo Maniacs, but let us know if you got something better. Basically, they'll spend time helping out in the comments section by pointing people towards our suggestion tool, by linking older videos they've requested, and just generally getting everyone hooked even faster.
Speaking of which, we wanted to give a shout out to our user ItZwan, who's really taken initiative in helping our viewers find what they're looking for. If you're ready to take your level of engagement with WatchMojo to the next level, we invite you to be part of the WatchMojo Fellowship.
One does not simply join the fellowship. To be considered for inclusion, please send an email to watch@watchmojo.com telling us a little bit about yourself and why you'd be a good candidate for the fellowship.
Anyway, on to the next question. We got an email from our user Robert Pover that reads, concerning WatchMojo's top 10 jailbait songs. The Beatles, I Saw Her Standing There. Here in good old Blighty, the age of consent is 16. So for further reference, in the context of which they wrote it, it isn't technically jailbait. Yours faithfully, Rob.
We have to take into consideration that over half of our audience is in the US of A. And for jailbait songs, we figured we'd get a lot of comments pointing out possible omissions. So we figured 18, cutoff point, called it there.
Now this sort of ties into a common refrain we get about our American-centric top 10s. But first things first, we're Canadian, eh? If you want to know where we're from and more, check out Top 10 Origins of WatchMojo, 10 Things You Need to Know. So any accusation of bias is ridiculous. There, lawyered.
A lot of media companies have the majority of their audiences in the US, so it makes sense that a lot of their programming would be US-centric. But while many outright ignore the rest of the world, we don't. We try to make our lists as representative as possible, but we don't pander by throwing in a non-US entry if the list doesn't deserve it.
What's kind of ironic about the whole thing is that many of you came to love WatchMojo because we cover American pop culture, and yet at the same time you criticize us for being US-centric.
That said, and this may surprise you, in addition to WatchMojo's main channel, you can watch hundreds of videos in French on our French channel at youtube.com/watchmojofr.
Bien sûr. We have also done pilots in German, Spanish, and Mandarin. Yes, Mandarin. And we are flirting with the idea of launching local editions to cater to local tastes and to dub or at least subtitle some of our content.
If you're interested in that, leave your feedback in the comments. Who knows, maybe WatchMojo will be coming to a neighborhood near you.
Before we finish, we're going to tell you about another new thing that we're doing. Every day, we're going to try to post a comment of the day, which is one of your comments that we find funny or noteworthy or something. This can come from either Facebook or Twitter or YouTube or wherever, so commenters, bring your A-games.
And we thought we'd read one or two of last week's good comments. Eric Weiss posted on Top 10 Movie Treasure Hunters, I freaked out when they showed Indiana Jones as they were going into the honorable mentions, was going to go on a profanity-laced tirade about how insane they are. Luckily, all is well.
Wanton Wabledu, I think, posted on Top 10 Ridiculous Infomercial Products. I have a Snuggie. I got the limited edition camouflage one that's ironically still sold in stores 3 years later. I actually like it. I wear it like a Jedi robe more than using it as a blanket, though.
Purple Dimitrodon posted in Top 10 Animated Dogs in Movies and TV, Where Was Blue from Blue's Clues? That show is amazing. I have even put watching the show into my daily schedule. Sure, Scooby, Pluto, and Snoopy are cool, but Blue is not only the best animated dog ever, but Blue is the best character from media. You have to agree with me here.
Virtue Fernandez posted on top 10 movie continuations of TV series. Friends. I think that's all of them. For God's sake, make a Friends reunion movie!
And last but not least, Rand Brandt commented on top 10 Superman villains. Am I the only one who watches Watch Mojo videos when I'm taking a dump? Lovely. Anyway, guys, thanks as always for the comments and questions.
And of course, if you want yours answered, leave them here in the comments. Hit us up on Twitter or Facebook, or email us at watch@watchmojo.com. Don't forget the hashtag WMFAQ, and if you want a shirt, head over to watchmojo.com/store. That's all for this week. Tune in next time for another edition of What's Your Mojo? This is Rebecca Brayton saying...